the Fulu communicated entirely in rhyme. Although that's actually less impressive than it sounds, because their language only contained one vowel. Also, if you've noticed, the only artifacts we've been able to unearth are primitive musical instruments. The Mafulus had plenty of drums, guitars, harmonicas, and the like, but no weapons or tools. So in essence, they had rhythm, they had music, but they had no hammers and spears, so they died. In any case, this brings us to the final room of the tour, and my personal favorite, the Hall of Norse Mythology. This is Odin, chief divinity of the entire Norse pantheon, the All-Father, as he's called. And these paintings depict some of Odin's many sons. That is Thor, god of thunder, with his mighty hammer. And this is Balder, god of beauty.
Who's that ugly guy?
Oh, I was just about to get to him. That's Loki, Norse god of mischief. He was also known as the Trickster. As the youngest son of Odin, Loki was the black sheep of the Norse mythological family. His constant mischievous pranks were an endless source of embarrassment to his father and his siblings. He was, in other words, a bratty little brother. And Loki's ultimate tool of mischief was this, the mask, which he created and tossed down during thousands of years ago to create mayhem among the mortals. For, according to legend, the wearer of the mask is imbued with the powers of Loki himself.
Is that true?
No, of course not. If it were, I'd be wearing it myself. No, it's textbook mythical allegory. Loki represents...